Okay, it's March 12th, 2013 it's actually 10:23. I left the time on my camera an hour ahead before, and I keep deducting an hour because of this bull daylight savings time crap that we just did about a week this last Sunday. But it is 10:23 Central Time, a.m. I started my garden, I got my tiller fixed. My brother helped me out a little bit with that. But anyway, get back to this. These are all heirloom seeds. Everything I grow is heirloom. I don't go buy the crap at that store called China Mart. Some people of you refer to it as Walmart, but it is in fact China Mart. The practices of that store are atrocious. But I've got a sunflower right there growing. I have another one planted right next to it. I've got all these others written down. I don't memorize what all I have, but I do know that the far two center ones there, no, I went by twos, are cherry tomatoes. And I have one, two, three. Oops, I'm not even looking in the viewfinder again. In three of those. Then I had Rutgers tomatoes in the next. I thought I put two seeds in each one, but there's three in this one, and I have one growing up on this one. I know there should be another seed in at least in that one. And then I have the other tomato. What's the other big one? Let's see. Mariglobe. See, I got it down there on the card. So I know I had two of everything in there. That's why I say for three to be growing out of that one, I somehow or another dropped the next seed in there. Then over here I have two peppers on the left, one black-eyed pea in this one here by itself. One black-eyed pea in that one, and one black-eyed pea in there. So three total, but one in each of these little planters. Then I have peppers in the other ones, the ones next to it. Two seeds of each of the pepper in that. Again, I got mixed up because I was in a hurry to get this stuff going before, and then it got cold and it got warm again. I've got five Wonder Peppers in here, and I also put in two jalapeno pepper seeds in here. I just did that a couple days ago, so nothing's growing out of that yet. I have three cayenne peppers in here, and three habanero peppers in here I just got from Solutions from Science, if you want habanero peppers. Okay, here I am. I screwed up on this too. I planted these same time I planted all these in the small planters. And these two, three of them are growing, four of them are actually growing, coming out right now. See right there, there, and there. Again, I don't know, I was in a hurry to get this stuff started and excited because I had, you know, I got the right soils, I've got the right heirloom seeds, and I got the extra potting now that I can do all these plants. Now I'm waiting for the weather to break. But I believe these are long green pod okra, and the red, burgundy red okra. And again, I don't remember exactly which is which. Let me pause this for a second. I almost forgot down here below, I've got a long planter down there, which I hope to goodness I have a card. I wrote what was on there. This is my filtered water. This is well water here, but it's farmland out there, and unfortunately the owner of the property who's out there, I won't go in on it, he uses Monsanto seed and the, what do you call it, the herbicides, I guess, pesticides, all that crap, which, you know, is not healthy, and it soaks into the ground, and it gets into the water supply, because even though I know the water moves, there's a water duct or such under the land here, I filter it with my Berkey light, and I rebottle it in these gallons, and every 5 to 6 months, I put the date on it, and then 5 to 6 months after that, I try to make sure I use up that gallon of milk by that time, and put a new fresh gallon of water, filtered water. I have about 12, 15 gallons. I want to get a 60 gallon tank soon. This one here, oh yeah, there's the one. I have one Roma bean. I have some artichoke in the middle, and I have more Wonder Peppers on the right side over here. So, and again, these need to be watered today. Yesterday I didn't water them. Day before, I think, or the day before that, I did water them, and I haven't done them since. But these others I've been trying, I keep not really thinking about this one down here. But it's over here on the south window. The sun coming up on the east to left. And it goes over the house, and in the summer, spring, I'll be out here in another week or so. Keep them outside as much as I can. I don't want to keep them out when it gets down into the 30s at night. Especially when they're like this right here, that will kill them. And tomatoes are very, sensitive. Okay, so hold on a minute. Okay, there's my solar panel for the generator I got from Solutions from Science. I haven't used that yet. I'm waiting to get out there maybe this weekend or maybe even the next couple days when it gets a little warmer. I don't want to go out there and freeze my butt. I've got some canned food, as you can see behind, stored up a little bit. My Berkey Light water filter. And now let's go. Over here are some more things I've bought, like I say, from China Mart mainly because, you know, if they close everything else down, what are you going to do? You can't go anywhere, you know. But anyway, I hate dwelling on that friggin' place. Anyway, that's more planters than I have. The ones that will plant directly into the soil. Heirloom seeds. I've got, trust me, folks, I have some heirloom seeds. I mean, once you start growing your vegetables with heirloom seeds, which I have, I've got bags and bags of seeds from last year. After my garden went south, you know, I didn't upkeep it or anything like that, but I tried to keep it going. I still harvested some seeds from things, and it's just one bean plant. I've got almost a pint-sized bag full of beans. And you can use each one of those beans, well, not each and every one, because I've got a DVD from Solutions from Science on how to sort through your seeds. But, you know, when you get heirloom seeds, you have an abundance. You have a never-ending source of food. That's why you buy the crap at China Mart, and I'm not going to call it by the other name because it is China Mart. When you buy the seeds from China Mart, a lot of them are, I don't know if they call it open pollinated or whatever, but they won't produce seeds or they won't produce quality seeds. And if they do, the seed that you bought originally has been tampered with, has been genetically modified. Think about it. If Monsanto genetically modifies their seeds with insecticide that kills insects that eat their seeds so that you can have vegetables, doesn't that, it's poison. Does anything click inside the head there, hello? That you're eating something that kills something else, but you're going to eat it and build up, what, an immunity to it? Duh. Gee, wonder why cancer is so off the charts in this country. Wonder why other countries don't want a lot of our food, especially our meat. If I could get a place where I knew someone who had their own cattle, which there is some down the road here, they would slaughter it. I would eat their beef because this guy's got a field down here in the distance. Actually, I'm going to pause this and go to there and then show you that part next. I'm willing to buy a side of beef from him at least. So just let me pause this and I'll be right back on here in a second. Okay, I'm back over here on the south side of the house, and in the distance, there's cows over there, a couple of donkeys, two or three donkeys, I believe. I don't know if it's any mules. Shetland, I've seen three or four Shetland ponies, I guess you call them. But anyway, the man over there, I forget his name, but I'll talk to him some more. I thought about that maybe. Getting a side of beef. I can't keep my hands steady. I know, I'll try something. Put my elbows on the planter here. Alright, where would I see that? I guess he's got some horses. Oh, and that might be one of the donkeys. Jesus, crappy camera. That's zoomed in as far as I can get. He's got two or three donkeys, four donkeys, and maybe a couple mules. So, anyway, that would be a good source for maybe getting a side of beef or two, you know, depending on his price, and it would be fresh, because that's what they eat. That's what your good cattle will eat, is grass and hay from the area here, which, again, everything is contaminated with the chemtrails and such, but overall, that's better than the crap you're going to get in a store where they keep them suckers in little cages all their lives, inject them with all kinds of crap, feed them all kinds of crap to make them fat and disease-free. I mean, come on, then you eat that stuff, man. So, got to do the best you can to be as healthy as you can. I'm going to try the best I can for my wife and I. And my little babies, Lucy, Petey, CJ, and a little bit. So, alright everybody, stay safe. Try to get yourself some vegetables, preferably heirloom seeds. Do the best you can to grow it yourself, wherever you can. Even around the house, if you have little spots up against your house. Or tomato plant, pepper plant, whatever. So, I've got a whole wide variety, which will help for bartering, perhaps, in the future if I need to. Now, my next step is getting a hand pump so I can get into that well if the electricity goes out. Stay safe and protect your families.